शुक्लांबरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् सदास्मेरवक्त्रं कृपापूर्णनेत्रं स्थिरं दीनमित्रं जनप्रीतिपात्रं सुविज्ञातशास्त्रं कषायाप्तवस्त्रं दयानन्दरूपं मदाचार्यमीडे from 1712
Jayaya Jaya Bhadraya Haryashvaya Namo Namaha Namo Namas Sahasramshaha Adityaya Namo Namaha Namo Ugraya Viraya Sarangaya Namo Namaha Namo Padma Prabodhaya मार्तांडाय नमो नमः ब्रह्मेशानच्युतेशाय सूर्याय आदित्यवर्चसे भास्वते सर्वभक्षाय रौद्राय वपुषे नमः तमोघ्नाय हिमघ्नाय शत्रुघ्नायामितात्मने कृतघ्नघ्नाय देवाय ज्योतिषां पतये नमः चामीकराभाय मन्हये विश्वकर्मणे नमस्तमोभिनिघ्नाय रुचये लोपसाक्षिणे नाशयत्येष वै भूतं तदेव सृजति प्रभुः पायत्येष तपत्येषः वर्षत्येष घभस्तिभिः एष सुप्तेषु जागर् भूतेषु परिष्ठितः एष एवाग्निहोत्रं च
வாய்ஸ் கட் ஆறது ஃபேஸ் தெரியல
क्रतवश्चैव क्रतूनां फलमेव च यानि कृत्यानि लोकेषु सर्व एष रविः प्रभुः रविः प्रभुः ओके यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दैट इन माय रिकॉर्डिंग यू विल नो यू मस्ट हैव नोटिस्ड इट इफ यू आर लिसनिंग टू द रिकॉर्डिंग नॉट दिस क्लास रिकॉर्डिंग बट चैंटिंग रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन द वेबसाइट दिस रविः प्रभुः ओके Vedascha, cha means indeed, okay? Vedaha, he indeed is the Vedas. Who? Surya Bhagwan, Aditya Bhagwan. And Kratavascha iva, Kratavaha cha iva, eva, okay? As well as the fire rituals. He is the Veda and he is also the rituals which is prescribed in the Veda. And kratunam phalameva cha. Phala means, you know, result. Kratunam phalam means the result of the rituals also. So he is the Veda, he is the rituals, and he is also the result of the rituals. Yani krityani, whatever duties are there, sarveshu lokeshu, in all the worlds, whatever duties are there, एषः रविः प्रभुः आदित्य अलोन इज द प्रभु प्रभु मीन्स लॉर्ड ही इज द लॉर्ड सो व्हाट इज ही ट्राइंग टू से हियर ही इज ओनली सेइंग दैट ऑल दैट इज हियर इज ईश्वर अलोन नथिंग इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईश्वर सी देयर आर सेवन विभक्तिज इन ग्रामर डिक्लेंशंस ओके नॉमिनेटिव अक्यूसेटिव इंस्ट्रूमेंटल डेटिव अब्लेटिव जेनेटिव लोकेटिव रामः रामं रामेण रामाय रामात् रामस्य Rami. Okay. Ramaha, the subject, okay. Nominative. Ramam will be the object, accusative. Ramena, by Rama. Ramaya, for Rama. Ramat, from Rama. Ramasya, of Rama. Rame, in Rama or on Rama or into Rama. Like this, declensions are there in grammar. Every language has it. Declension is there. So when you look at it, it appears like there are many things, right? That which something comes from something, then something is put into something, somebody is putting something into something, somebody is doing something to the other person. So there seems to be too many things involved here. But the truth is, they are not separate from each other. That is the vision of the Vedanta, the vision of the Upanishads, because they are all one. There is only one vastu which appears in different forms. In South, they have this kulu. During Navaratri, they will arrange various dolls made of clay. So the dolls are of animals, birds, vegetables, human beings, the devas, the rishis, the munis, ladies, men, children, everything, you know, grass, everything will be there. See, everything is arranged in a particular, but all these are nothing but only clay. So all these are made only of clay. Even though there are many reference to the name and form, but when it comes to the truth of all the vastu, the only vastu is there is clay. So all that is there is only clay. Similarly, the Veda, the one who performs the rituals, the one who offers the rituals, one who offers whatever is being offered into the Agni, and whoever is enjoying the result of the karma and the very result itself, everything is Ishvara alone. So we have a shloka in Bhagavad Gita. Brahmarpanam Brahmahavihi Brahmagno Brahmanahutam Brahmaivatena Gantavyam Brahmakarma Samadhina. So this is usually chanted before having food. It is not a prayer. The shloka is not a prayer, definitely. We are not praying anything. We are not even thanking Bhagavan in this for the food. That we can say for Annapurne, Sadapurne, Shankara Pranavalabhi, Jnana Vairagi Siddhyatam. There also we are asking for Bhiksha. And Bhiksha in the form of Jnana Vairagya. Not even for the body. We are asking for our Moksha Icha. To fulfill the Moksha Icha, we are asking for Jnana and Vairagya. The hunger for freedom. For that hunger, we are asking qualifications from Annapurani. And also, of course, for the regular hunger also. So even though it is chanted before having food, it is not a prayer. This verse reveals the knowledge the Upanishad is talking about. That one verse. It says all that is here is only Ishvara, the Brahma. The meaning is, the means of offering is Brahman. Whatever is offered, the oblation is Brahman. The fire into which the oblation is offered is Brahman. The one who is offering is Brahman. The one who is receiving it is Brahman. And Brahmaiva tena gantavyam Brahma karma samadhina. Brahman indeed is to be reached, to be known by him who sees everything as Brahman. It is a very popular verse. One of the popular verses in Bhagavad Gita. So why we say it before having food? Because eating is compared to a Agni ritual. It's like a havan, homa. We offer food, the one who is offering, the one who is eating, me, I am the karta. The instrument which is being used is my hand. Okay. The fire is the jar offered. So the one who is enjoying the food, the one who is giving the food, one who is receiving the food by which it is offered, everything is Ishvara alone. Iti. That's why this shloka is said before having food. So here Aditya is in the form of Veda. The Veda itself is Aditya Bhagavan. He is the Kratavaha. The rituals and also he is the Kratunam Phalam, the result of the rituals. And Krityani Lokeshu, all the duties in the world are also Eshaha Eva, Surya alone. Who is he? He is Ravi Prabhu, Ravi Prabhu, Lord Surya, Lord Aditya. So next shloka. Enam apatsu krichreshu kantareshu bhayeshu cha kirtayan purushah kashchit navasidati raghava. Hey Raghava, kashchit purushah, any person. Kashchit means any purushah, any person. Purushah here doesn't necessarily mean man. Purushah means a person here. Enam, this stotram on Surya Bhagavan, kirtayan, when he recites, when chanted, when apatsu, in times of danger, krichreshu, krichra means difficulties, could be financial difficulties, emotional, physical, and any relationship issues like employer-employee relationship, or neighbors, relationship with your neighbors, or relationship with your friends, or parents, or children, or spouse, or in-laws, or government officials, poor, any relationship, if you have any problem, any difficulties, life situations during such times, and kantareshu, when you are stuck in the forest. In those days, people had to cross forests to go from one place to the other. Nowadays, there are no forests. But still, if you have a situation which makes you feel like you are in a forest, feeling threatened or lost or alone, you don't know which direction to choose, whether this is left or right or east or west, you don't know. Sometimes we get so stuck in life, we do not know where we are and which direction to turn. Is anybody there? Sometimes it's so dark. It's not physically dark, but the buddhi, you know, it doesn't function. It looks like there is no way out. You're stuck. And when you're stuck, you're afraid. You freeze. And you feel lost and helpless. So such situations are there in life. So kantareshu, even though it is not literally you're not stuck in a forest, but situations like that in your life. Suppose if somebody is in the military, in the armed forces, our soldiers, they have to be out there in the forest, you know, sometimes poor fellows. So we can recite for them. Even if we are not there and if some of your relatives are there, your son or daughter or somebody is there, you can recite for them, can chant for them, for their sake you can do. Or if they know, they can also chant Adityahrdayam. And Bhayeshu, when there is fear, a fearful situation, when there is terror, panic, you feel insecure, feel very apprehensive, there is anxiety and there is some phobia, all shades of fear, okay, all shades of fear, Bhayeshu, at the time when you are afraid. Na avasidati. For such person, when you are in such situations, you recite Adityahrdayam Stotram, dukkham will not come to you, grief will not come to you. You won't be subject to grief. Means you will be relieved from all these things. Surya Bhagavan will protect you. Iti Arthaha. Or Ishwara will protect you. Hence you recite Adityahrdayam. Generally, kirtan means bhajan. That is singing. Of course, we won't definitely sing when we are in distress. Nobody will be... sometimes even the voice will not come out, you know. The sound will not come out. When you are afraid and when you are stuck somewhere, when you are having anxiety. So the meaning is, kirtan means remembering. Manasika recitation, manasika chanting. Or you can loudly also say, Ugraya, Viraya, Sarangaya, Namo Namaha, Rakshaksha. You can say that also, we can say. Whichever way. So if you say this, Bhagavan will definitely protect you. No dukkham will come to you. No grief will come to you. Next shloka. Puja yasvaina mekagraha deva devam jagatpatim. Etat trigunitam japtva yudhesh vijayishyasi. Puja yasva. He Rama Mahabaho. Rama Rama Mahabaho. He started like that, right? Agastya Maharishi. May you worship. Puja yasva. May you worship. How? Ekagraha san. With single pointedness. Single pointedness is possible only when you have Shraddha. So it's faith in Adityahrdaya Stotram. So you should have the Shraddha that when I recite this Adityahrdaya Stotram, it will give me all the phalam. All the phalam was mentioned by Agastya Bhagavan in the beginning itself. So that assurance is already given that you will be taken care of. Any questions you can ask at the end of the class. I will answer later. Because when I see, when somebody sends a message, it keeps on blinking here and it distracts. I get so, I have to stop the class. You can ask questions at the end of the class. Ekagraha means, I told you, it's single-pointedness. And it implies Shraddha and faith. Enam. So in this manner, which manner? With ekagrata mind, whoever chants Adityahrdaya Stotram, for that person, no dukkha will become. And so Rama, you also with ekagrata do worship of Surya Bhagavan. Have Shraddha. It doesn't mean Rama didn't have Shraddha. Agastya has to say that, you know, when you're doing an Upadesha, the Guru has to give all these instructions to the Sishya, even if the Sishya knows about it. And that is the procedure. That is how it is done. Then Niyati is like that. And he is Jagatpatim. And Lord of the universe. Jagatpatim Devadevam. Worship, do puja. Either kaikam or vachikam or manasam. Whichever is convenient for you. Kaikam means you have to do it as a panchopachara puja or shodashopachara puja. You have to sit and do the, you have to have a murti and do puja. Dupam, deepam, nevedyam, karpura nirajanam, everything will be there. Or you can just chant. You can just recite Adityahrdaya Shlokam. Say manasam. Do manasa puja or manasa recitation. Everything is fine. It's all your convenience. Depends on how much Shraddha you have and how much bhakti. That's all. How many times should I recite this? etat, this praise, this stuti, this stotram, trigunitam japtva, chant three times. Our Agastya Maharishi himself has said three times. Trigunitam, trigunitam japtva, chanting three times, O Rama, yuddhesh vijeshyasi, you will achieve victory in the battle. Or any situation you want to avoid, you will be relieved from that. So how long will it take to get the result? Next question, no? If I do this, doctor, if I take this medicine, how long will it take for me to be relieved? You will ask. Similarly, this is also a medicine. This mantra is like a medicine. And dukkham is like a roga. So how long will it take for this medicine to work? Asmin kshane mahabaho ravanam tvam vadishyasi. Eva muktva tadagastyo jagamacha yathagatam. Hey mahabaho, hey Rama. Asmin kshane, at this very moment, without any delay. Asmin kshane means what? You recite it three times and you do what needs to be done. Then immediately you will see the result. So asmin kshane mahabaho, ho ravanam tvam vadishyasi. You will kill Ravana. You will be able to kill Ravana. It doesn't mean that Rama was incapable of killing Ravana. Rama was postponing killing of Ravana. Because Rama by nature always wants to understand what's happening, give some time for a change of heart. So Rama is like that. Rama is a very compassionate person and his nature is to avoid killing any jiva. But Agastya, when he approached Rama, I have already told you this, it is not that Rama was depressed and he needs some psychotherapy and all that. Not like that. Rama has to live like a human being. Nara, that is what Ravana's boon was. Only a human being can kill me. So even though it's an avatara, the avatara has to behave like a normal human being, ordinary human being. So the role has to play perfectly, isn't it? So Mahavishnu has to pretend that he is a ordinary human being and he has to go through whatever confusions and worries a human being will go through. He was just playing his role well. And following the script perfectly. And Agastya also has to go along with whatever script was given to him. And he approaches Rama and teaches him Adityahrdayam. So through who are really benefiting by the teaching. So Agastya on behalf of all the devas reminds Rama of the purpose of the avatara. That is what he is doing at that time. See, even for us, sometimes somebody has to come and tell us about our strength. So like this, for Hanuman also somebody had to go and tell him, hey, you are not an ordinary person, you can cross the ocean, your strength is this, that. Then after that, Hanuman was able to cross the ocean. Sometimes people have to come and tell us what we are capable of. It's not that we are incapable. So Agastya, on behalf of all the devas, is actually approaching Rama to remind Rama who he is, what he is capable of. So he urges Rama to kill Ravana. Through this Adityahrdaya Upadesha, what he is feeling is, Ravanam tvam vadishyasi, you will be able to kill Rama, which means, hey, come on, go and kill him. Come on. That's what he's telling. This Ravana was given many warnings and many opportunities, you know, that he doesn't seem to really listen to anybody. He chased away Vibhishana also. So he's not going to change or realize. There is no point in giving him more time. The killing of Ravana was not just for the sake of Sita. Many people think Rama went and killed Ravana for his wife. No. Sita was only a nimitta. Before that, he has kidnapped so many women and he has married them also. Sita refused to marry. If Sita also had married, then Ramayana wouldn't have been there, you know. Sita refused. So Rama had to go. And she wanted Rama to come and rescue, not even Hanuman. Hanuman also. I come and rescue. That's what Sita said. And so Rama did not kill Ravana only for the sake of Sita. Sita was only a nimitta. And kidnapping Sita is not the only atrocity Ravana did. He has done a lot more for many centuries. Devas and Manushyas have been victims of Ravana's atrocities for many, many centuries. He caused terror, bhiti, along with his family and friends and the Rakshasa Vamsha. All of them were there. And they were all having a very good time. So it has to end. Time for Swachh Bharat. Like that. We have to do some cleansing. So Agastya says, Ravanam tum adishyasi, you pray to Aditya Bhagavan. So evam uktva, having said this, Agastya tatha agatam tatha jagam. Just as he came, he went. How did he come? Not only the root, but he came quickly and left quickly. He finished his work. Just like that, he came and just like that, he left, finished his work and he left. Etatshutva mahatejaha nashtashoko bhavattada dharayama. Etatshutva, having heard this stotram, this sthiti. And along with the palam also. The stuti along with the palam as told by Agastya Maharishi was really encouraging to Rama. Etat Shrutva Mahatejaha Rama, the brilliant one. Mahateja means one who is very brilliant, of extraordinary energy and strength and intelligence. That Mahateja Rama Tada, then Nashta Shoko Bhavat became free from sorrow. His worry was destroyed. So Rama was as though worried and as though happy. So that is the avatar Leela. Then Supritaha, feeling very greatly pleased, Raghavaha, Rama, Dharayamasa means he meditated upon Surya Bhagavan. So the meditation was not a broken meditation, like a dhara. You know, dhara means flow. Just like the oil flows, you know. When the oil is flowing, you don't know whether the oil is flowing or it is just a thin kambi. You don't, unless you touch, you won't know whether it is flowing or not. There's a flow without any disturbance. So dharayamasa prayatatmavan, with a devoted mind, he meditated upon Surya Bhagavan with a very devoted mind. And he decided to recite Aditya Bhagavan. Adityahrdayam. Yuddha Parishantam. Okay? That is only for us. He started from the 7th verse. Starting from 7th verse up to 24th verse is actual Adityahrdaya Stotram. Before that, Agastya is talking to Rama. After 24th verse also, Agastya is addressing Rama and telling him, Rama, you say this, you will win. All that is said. It's a conversation. The 7th verse to 24th verse is the actual Suti. Adityam preksha japtvatum param harshama vaptavan triracamya suchir bhutva dhanuradaya viryavan ravanam preksha hrishtatma yuddhaya samupagatam. சர்வயத்னேன மகதா வதே தஸ்ய த்ருதோ பவத் ஸ்ரீராச்சம்ய ஹிடிட் ஆச்சம்னம் அச்சுதாய நமஹ அனந்தாய நமஹ கோவிந்தாய நமஹ. ஈவன் ராமா ஹஸ் டு சே தட், யூ நோ, வென் ஹி டஸ் ஆச்சமனம் ஹி ஹஸ் டு சே அச்சுதாய நமஹ அனந்தாய நமஹ கோவிந்தாய நமஹ. ஹி கான் சே ஹே ஹவ் கேன் ஐ ரிபீட் மை ஓன் நேம், நோ, ஹி ஹஸ் டு சே அச்சுதாய நமஹ அனந்தாய நமஹ கோவிந்தாய நமஹ. தென் சுச்சிஹி பூத்வா பிகமிங் பியூரிஃபைட், சுச்சிஹி மீன்ஸ் பியூரிஃபைட். So when you sip the water, how do you purify? How do you get purified suddenly? So the water actually does not purify. The water that you sip doesn't purify. In that case, every day we are drinking water, you know, bottle after bottle, we are drinking water. That water doesn't purify. The water purifies because as you sip, you say the name of Bhagwan. So actually what purifies is the name of Bhagwan. And since the name of Bhagwan has the shakti to cleanse you and water also has the shakti to cleanse, you bring together both the cleansing agents and drink that water. Along with the water, when you take Bhagwan Nama, the Bhagwan Nama spreads all over your mind and body. So Achamanam is actually for cleansing the mind. Because after, before that, you will already would have taken bath. Gange Chemane Cheva Godavari Saraswati, you would have taken bath. And here you take the name of the Lord and cleanse yourself. That is how you charge the water with the name of the Lord and sip it. So having done this, Prekshya. Looking at what? Adityam. Adityam Prekshya. Rama is looking at Surya Bhagavan. And Japtva, and repeating this prayer. He repeated this Adityahrdaya Stotra. Who Viryavan, the valiant Rama, Param Harsham Avaptavan. Then after reciting Adityahrdayam, he had great happiness. He became very happy. Happy means he was relieved from sorrow. Once sorrow is not there, your nature is happiness, right? He was happy. Then what did he do? Dhanuradaya. He took hold of his bow. So when you are tired, and even in Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna, when Arjuna was depressed, his bow was not in his hand, right? He kept it aside. Here also Rama, it doesn't mean Rama kept the bow and arrow down, but he was not holding it properly. He was relaxed and was listening to Agastya. He was listening to his guru. So he must have kept it aside. Out of Maryada to Agastya, because some Upadesha is taking place. So he just got hold of his bow and Prekshya Ravanam. And seeing Ravana is coming, see, even though it took 9 classes for us for Adityahrdayam, because I was dealing with meaning, Agastya came and finished it very quickly, because when Agastya came to meet Rama, Ravana was actually returning, coming towards Rama. And Agastya had to very quickly teach Adityahrdayam and move away from there. Adityahrdaya Stotram was over. Rama recites it 3 times after doing Achamana. I don't know from where he got the water. How did he get the water from there? Oh, I don't know. Then Ravana is coming. He sees Ravana coming. Krishtatma. So he's feeling delighted in the mind. Because he's sure that this time he is going to be cancelled. Because deep within his heart he wanted to spare Ravana. Hereafter he is not going to spare Ravana anymore. So he's delighted. Aha. So once you make a decision, then you will have clarity, you know. Till you make that decision, if you are even 99%, I have decided that 1% means you have not decided, that's all. Full stop. Decision making means clear cut. And Samubhagatam, and Ravana was coming and he was approaching Rama for what? Yuddhartam, for the sake of fighting. And Rama was resolved. And Tasya Vade, what? In killing of Ravana, he was very much resolved now. Mahada sarva yatnena. He is going to put all his effort, you know, with intense and all effort. He is going to put all effort to kill Ravana. He has made up his mind. Athara viravadan niriksha ramam muditamana paramam prahrishyamanaha nishicharapati samukshayam viditva suraganam adhyagato vachasvareti. Atha, then Ravihi is Lord Surya. Muditamanaha means he became very pleased. Aditya Bhagavan became pleased because the prayer was done by Rama. Pleased with Rama's prayer and pleased that at last Rama was resolved to kill Ravana. Great relief, you know, for all the devas. And Ramam Nirikshya, and seeing Rama, Paramam Prahrishyamanaha. He became very happy seeing Rama. Aditya Bhagavan also became very happy seeing Rama because Rama was worried and they were also worried. Now Rama is happy, they are also happy because they know for sure that Rama is going to finish off. At last the avatara purpose is going to be fulfilled. And Viditva, knowing that Rama has finally decided to kill Rama, he was very happy. Nishichara Pati Samukshayam. So knowing Viditva, knowing that Rama was finally going to kill Ravana, what type of Ravana? Nishichara Patim Samukshayam. So Nishichara means the one who is active at night. Okay. The Rakshasas are active at night. That is why we should not indulge in any or loud or activities in which asuras will usually indulge, you know, like drinking and other things. You should not do all that at night. So can I do it during daytime? No, not like that. But at night it is worse. No? They are more powerful at night. So that's why no Shubhakaryam is done at night. And don't fight at night. You know, they will play with you, the Rakshasas. So all this is told. When you go to sleep, take Bhagavan Nama and sleep. Sleep peacefully. Don't fight. Don't worry. Just don't give the asuras any chance to come and do vishamam with you. So it is called Asura Vela. Night time is Asura Vela. So one has to be very careful. So he is the Pati Lord. Who? Ravana is the Pati, the Lord of Rakshasas who are active at night. Very active at night. Okay. More energetic and strong. So his samkshayam, his death is going to happen. Nishichara Pati Samkshayam is going to happen iti viditva. Surya Bhagavan was very happy. And Avadat, he spoke. He spoke to whom? Surya Bhagavan. To Rama. Spoke. Vachaha, the words. What did he say? Vara. Vara means hurry up. He did not go to Rama and say, hey, come on, hurry up. Not like that. Hurry up. Rama, please don't wait. Finish it off. He was also a spectator. He was in the audience. Suragana Madhyagataha. He was standing along with the devas and other celestial beings. So he looks at Rama and says, hey, Rama. So as a result of reciting Adityahrdayam, Aditya Bhagavan says, okay, come on. Now hurry up. My anugraha is there for you to kill Ravana. So you can take it that way also. So from the audience side, he said, of course, and he would have been excited and maybe he would have said loudly also, come on, hurry up. We have been waiting for so many years. We waited for you to be born. We waited for you to grow up. We waited for you to get married. We waited for you to go to the forest. Then we waited for 13 years. Then we waited for another 1 year for Sita to be in Ashokavana. It's almost now 13 years over and 14th year is going to be over. And in that 12 days are over. 12 days of battle also we have watched. very, very long waiting. Waiting, 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 we are tired. So, this is enough. Please save us. Oh, Rama, save us from this krataka, this rakshasa. So usually, you'll be waiting, 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 no? Waiting will be waiting patiently. But when the time comes, you know, when something is going to happen exactly, that's when you get very excited. That 1 second, 2 seconds, we can't wait. That's exactly the condition of the devas. So meanwhile, Ramana was coming closer. Okay, Adityahrdayam is over. So at least let me tell you, finish off the vadam, Ramana vadam. Okay. So meanwhile, Ramana was coming closer. He was on his chariot driven by black horses. And Rama told Matali, Matali, hey Matali, Ramana is coming. It looks like he's determined to destroy himself. He's coming as though he's going to destroy himself. So therefore, Matali, take care and march forward. Move forward. Take care means what? Be alert and cautious. This fellow has all the magical powers, this Ravana. He will do anything. So be cautious and be alert. So march towards, drive towards the chariot of the enemy whom I wish to destroy. And he says, hey Matali, drive without fear. With a steady heart. Hold the reins of the horses in a controlled manner and drive very swiftly. And here, after saying all this, Rama so sweetly, in a very polite and humble manner, he will tell Matali, hey Matali, you need not be instructed by me. You are so accustomed to driving the chariot for Indra. But I am so keen on fighting and killing Ravana, you know. So I'm just reminding you. I'm not teaching you to how to drive, but I'm just reminding you. So he says that very sweetly there and very polite, and he respects Matali. So Matali was extremely pleased with those words of Rama, and he starts driving very swiftly towards Ravana. And he crosses that chariot, you know, very close by. He just crosses and passes Ravana's chariot, and Ravana was so enraged. And there is a fierce battle between the two. Rama was also enraged. Ravana was also enraged. Both are equally strong. And both are intent on destroying each other. They wounded each other. Then at one point, Ravana hurled arrows at Matali. Okay, of course, Matali was not harmed because he was Indra's charioteer. So nothing can happen to Matali. But Rama was very furious. See, Rama will be very quiet when arrows are aimed at him. But if it is at Lakshmana or Matali, that's when he will get really angry. Because he is a protector, you know. Anything happens to whomever he respects and loves, he won't spare the one who is hurting them. So Rama also discharged thousands of arrows at Ravana. And the entire earth, you know, the whole ocean, mountain, forest, everything trembled. And at that time, the devas and the rishis prayed for the welfare of the brahmanas and the pashu and the cows. And it was a terrible, fierce battle. Then finally, Rama discharged Nagastra and cut off Ravana's head. But in its place, another head popped up. Rama chopped off that head also. But again, another head cropped up. So like this, hundreds of heads were chopped off by Rama. Then Rama started wondering. He couldn't understand what was happening. What could be the reason? With these arrows only, I have killed Maricha, Karadushana, Kabanda, Virada, and the same arrows he used to pierce through those 7 trees. Bali was killed. The ocean was also shaken up by these arrows. But why these arrows are so inefficient in killing Ravana? He was wondering. He couldn't understand what was happening. And he was so absorbed in this. He was actually enjoying it at this point. Then Matali told Rama, hey Rama, Why are you still carrying out this battle with Ravana? Don't you remember? Don't you remember that you have an astra given by Brahma? Use it. So here again, Matali has to remind Rama. You know, hey Rama, you have that Brahmastra, use it. Why are you standing and wondering? Why are you continuing to fight with this fellow? So just like a normal human being, Rama was still there. Then finally, Rama used Brahmastra, which tore the heart of Ravana. After the taking the life of Ravana, the arrow just disappeared. So once Ravana was killed, all the Devas, Kinnaras, Gandharvas, Siddhas, Rishis, Vanaras, and Vanaras especially, and Rama's friends and everybody, they all surrounded Rama and praised him. They were all so happy and relieved. So this is how Ravana Vadham took place. And it is because of Rama we received Adityahrdaya Stotram. And Adityahrdaya Stotram can be recited for anything. It's just like Mrityunjaya Mantra, which can be recited for anything. And Vishnu Sahasrana Nama. Similarly, Adityahrdayam. Generally, for any problems related to eyes, they recite Adityahrdayam. And some people recite it every Sunday. You remember the story of Satrajit who worshipped Surya Bhagavan and got the Shamantakamani. So you can worship Surya Bhagavan just for the sake of worshipping Surya Bhagavan. Need not be for any specific reason also. Because he is the Pratyaksha Devata. You can worship Surya Bhagavan. There are people in North who do dhupa, show Dupam, Deepam and offer Nevedyam also to Surya Bhagavan. Even women do that, I think, in North. So everybody can. There are many questions not to recite. These are Bhagavan's Nama. So you can recite Adityahrdayam. No issues. Definitely nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to happen means what? Nothing. No harm will come to you by reciting Adityahrdayam. So to recite Bhagavan Nama, there can't be any rules that women can say and women cannot say, men can say and all this. It's ridiculous. Stotram anybody can do. Okay, maybe certain mantras, even that, I don't know why they say you should not say. Women can't recite. But when it comes to stotras and shlokas, anybody can recite it. Nobody can stop you from that. So happily recite it and be benefited by Adityahrdayam. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.